All right, we back. Good Fellow Sports TV in the building. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, bell icon button, share the video. And Conor McGregor want to shoot the fade with 50 Cent. He tells the UK Sun, and I'll link two articles in the description, and the article link from the Sun at the XL Magazine. Over memes, XL Magazine got the memes that Conor McGregor posted about 50. Excuse me, 50 posted about Conor McGregor. Now, Conor McGregor goes on and says, we use, 50 as a promotional tool to build up the Floyd fight, and it worked, but, 50 kept disrespecting him going down the stretch with memes. He never really stopped, so McGregor said he wants to shoot the fade with 50. To me, it sounds petty. Remember, you was in, like, kindergarten, preschool, pre-K, first grade, they used to say, sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. That's bullshit. These even dudes with millions and millions of dollars, and he got the proper 12 whiskey. It's funny that I mentioned that. It's because he sent some to Vladimir Putin, and Putin tested it for poison. He didn't trust Conor McGregor. Probably don't trust anybody. But that was a funny little story. But even these dudes with egos and millions of dollars, they still sensitive to that. They still, worried about people dragging their name through the mud. You had 50 posting, pictures of, Khabib making them tap out, and 50 never stopped. 50 is relentless. When the rap game ain't going good or power ain't coming on, 50 got to stay relevant somehow, and it's all entertainment. You know what I'm saying? And Conor McGregor, like, dude, all right, man, fight with Floyd over with, man, move on. I moved on. We promoted the fight the way we were supposed to. Now it's time to stop. But 50 don't know when to stop. And every day you watch 50 on the gram, or you watch 50 on social media, or you probably see him in everyday life if you got that perspective or that view. You see why somebody put 9 bullets in his ass. You know what I'm saying? Just going back, listening to, the stories about him and Ja Rule and where the beef started from. He a real, real funny type of dude, man. He real, real sensitive, dude. And, and McGregor the same way. If I'm McGregor, I ain't paying no attention to that. McGregor is probably the most popular combat sports fighter, in probably internationally, but he's the number one white combat sports fighter. No matter how many L's he take, he still can bounce back and do whatever he want to do. He can slam people's phones in Miami. He can punch an old man in the head. He can have some issues with women. People still gonna look at him in the light of endearment because he's a scarce commodity. You know what I'm saying? It ain't too many, white polarizing athletes out there, especially in America. I mean, who? Nobody really look at Mike Trout like that. Nobody watched hockey since the lockout like that. And in boxing, only thing he got to compete with is probably Tyson Fury. And I don't think that's no competition. Fury can go undefeated. He may never be put on the pedestal like Conor McGregor, but that just shows you these dudes sensitive and their ego is getting in the way. McGregor is looking to get clown show money. Clown show money make more money than UFC money and boxing money. You know what I'm saying? So you talking about, you see Tyron Woodley challenging Canelo, that make business sense. They make a ton of money doing that. You see Conor McGregor fight Floyd Mayweather, it's business sense. It made a ton of money by doing that. It's intriguing. It's a fantasy matchup that actually can happen. It's like saying who will win, Bruce Lee or Mike Tyson, or Mike Tyson and Muhammad Ali. That intrigues people. You know what I'm saying? Once you actually can make a fantasy fight reality, a ton of people are going to tune in. So, at the end of the day, for McGregor, he don't want to really go through that with Khabib again. He don't. Now, I mean, he wouldn't mind fighting him because the money would be right, but he don't want to work his way back up to being a championship fighter. He don't really want to, I know Tony Ferguson could be supposed to be fighting. He don't want to work his way back up in UFC on these showcase championship level fights as the main event. So he got to fight, probably a fight to be a champion, or they might even give him a champion fight coming in. But at the end of the day, that money ain't sufficient enough to really fund his lifestyle. The whiskey probably doing good, and he probably got other business ventures, but once you get a taste of that $100 million check that he made from Floyd, you want to get that money. Who don't? Who want to make $100 million and go back to making $5, $10, $11, $12 million? Nobody.
Nobody want to regress. Everybody want to progress. If anything, maintain the bare minimum. But, you know, if him and 50 fought in the Octagon, you know, 50 got a boxing background and they don't put no weight cap on there. McGregor like 5'8". You know, most he probably could come in as with like 180, 190. They say 50 about 218. He look a little bigger than that. I don't know how big he is. But, you know, he probably got some height on him. But then again, it ain't a street fight. It is an organized fight. But McGregor got them skills. He can use his legs. He can use his knees. He can use his hands. And at the end of the day, you know, I seen a lot of small dudes whip a lot of bigger niggas' ass. Or bigger men ass, excuse me. You know what I'm saying? I seen a lot of small dudes put in work. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, 50 will have to train for that. 50 may have to even lose some muscle to lean out, you know, for that. But I would favor Conor McGregor if they did fight. Even in the street, Conor McGregor is a trained MMA fighter. You know what I'm saying? Size don't mean everything. Now, if you go in a boxing ring, size will mean a lot. You know what I'm saying? But you still got to have that skill. But I don't think 50 will even entertain it. You know, would it be like a celebrity boxing match or something like that? But, you know, McGregor just trying to get that money either which way. But if 50 did beat him up, I think that's the one L that he can never recover from. You know, but McGregor about these fantasy matchups, though. Man, 50-50 known for punching. They said Ja Rule beat 50 up. You know what I'm saying? And 50 snuck him. One kept snucking him. And Ja Rule 50 pulled Ja Rule shirt over his head and started beating him up. Then they say Ja got with him. I like to see that happen. 50 and Ja, you know, in the ring. Maybe the Octagon, maybe in the boxing ring. And really kill that beef right there and bury that beef. But I doubt if 50 even entertained this dude. You know what I'm saying? That's the L that he probably couldn't recover from. But if he won, I mean, he'd be put on the pedestal like no other. But, you know, McGregor trained for that. You know what I'm saying? You know, that's like telling McGregor to out-rap 50. You know what I'm saying? McGregor ain't got no rap skills, but, you know, I think it'll make a lot of money, you know, if they did do it. But I think 50 won it in the street. And in the street, anything goes. It's a lot different in the street. 50 might pick up a trash can like Craig and hit Debo with it. RIP to John Witherspoon. You know, but, you know, McGregor said, like, dude, this dude, you know, do we ever stop? You know, we didn't promote the fight. We did this. I'm past Floyd. I'm going on other. And he just keep trolling me. But that just shows you how sensitive these dudes is, especially the smaller guys in boxing. You know what I'm saying? The smaller guys in boxing already got a small dude complex. You know what I'm saying? They've been made fun of their whole life. They've been short. You know, they didn't get the jock. They wasn't the jocks. They didn't get the cheerleaders, the bad bitches in school. You know, they always been smaller. And they always got a bone to pick with somebody. You know what I'm saying? And they always feel belittled. They hope, no matter how much you achieve, you know, when Floyd Mayweather was standing next to Maria Sharapova at the ESPYs, you know what I'm saying? She was towering over him. She made a short joke. Man, that shit still bothered them to this day. Majority of small fighters been short their whole life. You know what I'm saying? And McGregor wanted to prove a point they could beat 50. I'd love to see what 50 response is. You know what I'm saying? But they ain't even 50 lane. 50 probably going to troll him and, you know what I'm saying, make another meme about him. And McGregor going to have to find him in traffic, and we'll see what happens if you find him in traffic. But at the end of the day, you know, somebody need to square up with 50. You know, they act like motherfuckers scared of 50. You know, even Young Buck. Like, all this talking, he should have pulled up on 50, and he should have confronted him. Ja Rule, they from the same area. They be in the same area. And I know they say he a documented snitch. So I guess they scared not to touch him. I guess he like 6'9" before 6'9" even got out. But we have to see. But, you know, I think McGregor will beat him. You know, it make a lot of money. I watch that stuff. I ain't even going to lie. But, hey, let me know what you guys think. Good Fella Sports TV. Don't forget we on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out to the email. If you got a business question, inquiry, sponsorship, video request, want to make a donation, that link's in the description. Best way to donate is share the videos. And I link the articles in the description. You can see the memes. You can see exactly what McGregor said in the UK Sun. Appreciate the love, support. Check my other channel out, More to See Sports Talk. Check out our music entertainment playlist for more.